Hi everyone, very good evening to all of you.
Hello, ma'am.
Hi. So we'll be talking about writing task 2 today, which is known as an essay writing, and you have to devote good 40 minutes to complete this essay writing in your examination and even while practicing. The word limit for this is 250 minimum to 280 maximum words. So today we are going to talk about advantages and disadvantages type of essay, since it's the most lengthiest one. Advantages and disadvantages basically has three scenarios, and maximum questions in the IELTS exam basically comes either on agree disagree type of essay or on advantages and disadvantages. There are other two as well. Discuss both views and give your opinion plus set of questions. But today we'll be only discussing about discuss both views and advantages and disadvantages. So starting with the first one, advantage and disadvantage, like I mentioned, that there are three scenarios in total. First scenario is single situation question, wherein only one situation will be given and you'll have to interpret the question properly so that you basically analyze how many paragraphs are to be written and how do you have to write the main points and everything. The second one is dual situation question, wherein two situations will be given and you have to mention the advantages and disadvantages of both the situations. The last situation is outweigh and overweigh. Outweigh and overweigh basically means, again, two situation question, but it is mixed with outweigh and overweigh, wherein you have to write the advantages and disadvantages of a particular situation, outweighing or overweighing, which means one situation is more significant or prominent over the second situation. And the last, so this is the last scenario, and then we have discussed you. So we'll first begin with advantages and disadvantages type of essay, situation, single situation question. Any doubts so far? Okay. So, single situation, the very first question here is, people of some nations prefer to stay in a rented accommodation. Discuss the advantages and disadvantages of this situation. So here, the moment we get the question in front of our eyes, we have to first underline the keywords. Keywords are the main words, the words which actually contribute to the making of the entire question. Subject words or the main verbs, the action in the question. So here I can see that nations prefer stay rented accommodation. These five are the keywords in the entire question. While writing the introduction of the essay, of any kind of essay, you have to always underline the keywords first. Please note that you can use these keywords in the entire essay writing of IELTS and not any other word from the question. Which means while writing the introduction, you can only use the keywords underlined or highlighted in the question and you cannot use any other word. Make sure to use the synonyms of other words and do not repeat any of the word which is not a keyword or a subject word of the question. So again, people of some nations prefer to stay in a rented accommodation. Discuss the advantages and disadvantages of this situation. Now here, we have to mention both the advantage and the disadvantage of this situation, which means people staying in a rented accommodation have disadvantages as well as advantages. So no matter what, while writing an essay writing in IELTS, introduction, the paragraph of introduction, which is a major component of writing an essay, and the paragraph of conclusion will always remain same. So introduction will be one paragraph, conclusion will be one paragraph. So two paragraphs, and then we are told to write the advantage and the disadvantage of this situation, which is people staying in a rented accommodation. So there will be two body paragraphs which will carry the major information. The structure of this type of essay, single situation, advantage, disadvantage type of essay will be, paragraph one will be your introduction. Paragraph two will be your first body paragraph, wherein you will write one advantage of people staying in a rented accommodation and elaborating it, and paragraph 3 will be one disadvantage, elaborating it, and the final paragraph 4 will be your conclusion. Any doubts, guys?
Excuse me, ma'am.
Yes, please.
Ma'am, is there necessary to make the general statement in the first paragraph? like an introduction. We have to take the
just your name,
Prabhjot.
Okay, Prabhjot, what do you understand by writing the general statement or making the general statement?
Basically, when I was doing IELTS, I came to know that there is need to make a general statement along with the statement given in the question.
Okay, can you give me an example related to this question of writing a general statement in the first paragraph? How do you write it?
As I am not very much touched with the IELTS, so I hope how to do everything because I am not having my copy with me right away.
Okay, no problem. I understand.
About staying in the touch of the material. Once you left, you forget everything. What I feel is, so what I remember is there is need of general statement regarding, like the question should be modified and one statement which is accurate of all the times.
Okay, so yes, you're actually half right, half.
Like what I am saying is the third line of introduction is known as general statement, maybe.
Okay, so we don't call it a general statement. We actually call it a combination of general statement plus a background line. Okay, so that line is basically written in the introduction. I'll just tell you the steps of writing an introduction first. We always underline the keywords. We start with a phrase. The phrases can be, it is incontrovertible that, it is irrefutable that, it can be said that, it is undeniable that. You always have to begin your introduction and every other paragraph with a phrase.
Okay.
After writing the phrase, you have to basically understand. So if the question is single liner question, this question, if you look at this question, situation one, scenario one, single situation question, this is one liner question, which means while writing the introduction of this question, we will run out of words. The introduction will not be very big. It will be little small and we need everything to be in place. At least 30 to 35 words should be written in an introduction. Okay. So for that, we will basically write the background line, which you are calling it as a general statement. So anything related to this. And after that, we have to paraphrase the question using the main words from the question. Now, I'll just give you an example of this question, how the introduction will be. Okay. It is undeniable that finding an accommodation in today's time Hello.
Yes, Shruti, are you there?
Check it. I can't see the screen.
You can't see the screen. It's still there. Like from my end, it's there.
I'm not able to see it. It's all black.
Ma'am, okay. There will be network issues.
Okay. Thank you so much. So, Prabhjot, the introduction for this question will be, it is undeniable that finding the right accommodation in the right budget in today's time is a work of hassle. Then we are going to paraphrase the question that several individuals of several countries prefer or choose to stay in a rented accommodation rather than any other option or rather than buying their own house. You can add this from your own side. This is going to be the introduction of this question. I've started it with a phrase. I've written a background line. Then I have also paraphrase whatever is written in the question in my own words, using the synonyms wherever required and using the keywords as well. Have you understood?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So, general statement is basically a background line that we use when we feel that our introduction paragraph is going to be a little small. And we need to elaborate it just by adding a line. Okay?
Okay.
So, like I said, the very first paragraph is going to be introduction paragraph. Then we'll write one advantage. Make sure in IELTS you always write one main point in one paragraph. Okay? In one paragraph, in one body paragraph, you'll always write one main point and you'll elaborate it to the fullest to get a decent band in IELTS. So you will write the very first advantage of staying in a rented accommodation is, anybody? What can be the advantage, the major advantage of staying in a rented accommodation?
Major advantage. Yes, please continue.
The best advantage is the flexibility. When you change the job or the city, you can change your own residence also with a very
okay. Very nice. Yes, Piyush, please go ahead.
Other than that, there is a obvious financial motivation there is behind it. If you change, it requires a lesser number of the resources to take a rent, so that it is easy for a newcomer or new joining, so that it's preferable for one.
Okay, very nice. So, okay. All the students who are listening to me, I want to tell you something. Yes.
One more advantage I would like to point out is that we don't need to pay a bulk amount of money for purchasing a new apartment or something. By paying
good.
We can save a lot of money.
Right. And, very good. There are a lot of advantages. If you look at yes, please go ahead.
Moreover, we don't need to pay for the
please go ahead
maintenance expenses like preparing and all. We don't need to care about these things and all, so we can save money from that as well.
Okay, so please understand that there are a lot of advantages of staying in a rented accommodation. Okay, a lot of advantages are there. Now, what you need to focus more on is basically which point to choose, which particular advantage is the most important one that you're going to write in your body paragraph. So, out of all the advantages that I've heard in this session, for me, the most important advantage that I can think of is people with transferable jobs. There are bank employees, there are defense people, there are Navy people, there are a lot of people who basically who basically get job transfers after every few months or after every, let's say after a few years or after every year also sometimes. It is very easy for them to shift from one place to another. And they obviously, we can't keep on buying our own house at every place. Buy and sell. That is not possible for anybody. So the most important point of staying in a rented accommodation, the most important advantage is for people who have transferable jobs. It is very easy for them to move from one place to another and then stay in a place. You can also, whenever you feel like writing the second main point, try to link it with the first one. Now, the second main point that I felt right was the money thing, that everything is in budget. But I would say that is a controversial point because not every time you get a budget-friendly accommodation. But another point that I felt nice was we don't have to pay any charges or we don't have to do anything like we don't have to get anything built or construct anything. Anything we want is to be done by the landlord. You can add this point in such a way that it should be in sync with the first point. Rather than writing this as a second main point, try to make it, try to sync it with the first one so that this point comes in the elaboration of that main point and you get a big, beautiful paragraph at the end of your first body paragraph. You feel, yes, you've written everything right. It should be in a very symmetrical, in a very systematic manner. So I am looking at the chats right now. There is somebody who wants to understand the meaning of paraphrase. So paraphrase basically is writing something. Whatever is there in the question, we will write exactly the same thing, but in our own words and change. The meaning should be same, but the words should be different. We also call it as rephrasing. Okay. So moving on to the disadvantage of this single situation question, the disadvantage of staying in a rented accommodation can be What can be the please?
Oh yeah, it is. Maybe you have to shift everything every time. Like every time you have to take your things and then shift it. Like maybe 4 years, 5 years. Like you're used to some places, some things at some place, and then again you have to shift. So just like pack your things and again unpack. Even that can be one disadvantage. Like some things which are fixed in the apartment, so you need to keep things which are like flexible, which are like portable.
Okay, students, please understand, if we are writing one advantage in one paragraph, the disadvantage of that particular thing should not be a contradicting point of the first one. Like if I'm writing monetary issues in the your point in disadvantage, it is going to create a controversy between my paragraphs. Okay. So the disadvantage of staying in a rented accommodation is you do not have the autonomy of changing things as per what you want. Which means if you want to change the paint of the walls, you can't do it without the permission of the landlord. Okay. So this is one major point that can be written in the disadvantage of staying in a rented accommodation.
Okay, thank you.
Yeah. And the last paragraph will be conclusion paragraph, wherein you just have to start with to conclude. You have to write an overall view without being biased. Biased means you don't have to be partial with anything. Not with the advantage, not with the disadvantage. You can't say what you feel. This is not your opinion. You just have to write an overall view. For example, to conclude, different people have different opinions when it comes to, let's say, buying or staying in a rented accommodation, buying an accommodation or staying in an accommodation. And then after writing the overall view without being partial, you have to write an advice or a suggestion.
I think Piyush has something to say. He has raised his hand. Yes, Piyush.
Ma'am already paraphrased the same I was going to say. So continue, ma'am.
Okay. Thank you so much. So in conclusion, you will just take care of three things. You will always start with to conclude, then you will write overall view, and then you will write one advice or suggestion. No matter what type of essay you are writing, you will always try to write. In fact, not just try, you will always include one advice or suggestion in the conclusion of the entire essay. Okay. Any doubts so far?
No.
Any questions? No questions? Okay. So moving on to the second scenario, which is advantages and disadvantages. Question. Now in this, the question is very clear. People of several nations prefer to stay in a rented accommodation while people of other nations prefer to buy their own house. Situation 1, rented accommodation. Situation 2, own house. We have to talk about the advantages and disadvantages of both. Now, if I look at the question, there have been several students who've told me that we'll write 4 body paragraph or we'll write 5 body paragraphs. When we are writing an essay, minimum 2, maximum 3 body paragraphs will be written. Introduction, conclusion will be one paragraph. So total minimum 4 paragraphs and total maximum can be 5 paragraphs, not more than that. So in this, we will write one introduction, one conclusion. And in between, we will write 2 body paragraphs. Please listen to this very carefully. In this type of essay, we will write only 2 body paragraphs. Because we have to discuss about the advantages of own house and rented house, plus the disadvantage of rented house and own house. How are we going to write? Body paragraph 1, we will write one advantage of renting, one disadvantage, and then we will elaborate it. And then we'll write one disadvantage of own house and we will elaborate it. In body paragraph 2, whichever advantage you've written. So you've written one advantage of renting in the above paragraph. in the second body paragraph, you'll write one disadvantage of renting and one advantage of own house. Vice versa case. Shall I repeat it?
Yes, please, ma'am.
Okay. We have to write the advantages and disadvantages of renting an accommodation and staying in an own house. We are allowed to write only two body paragraphs. Okay. We have to fix everything in this, you know, fit everything in these two body paragraphs itself. Now we know that we have to write one advantage of staying in a rented accommodation, one advantage of staying in an own house, and the disadvantages of each. Now, while writing body paragraph one, please make a note of this. While writing body paragraph one, we will start with a phrase, like I said, then we will write one main point of advantage of renting, staying in a rented accommodation, one advantage of rented accommodation. Then we will elaborate it or explain it in 2-3 lines. And then we will write one disadvantage of own house. So advantage of renting accommodation can be trans people with transferable job. You'll explain this thoda sa, and then you'll write one disadvantage of own house, which means, heavy down payments, a lot of money spent on buying an own house. Then whichever advantage you've written in the above paragraph, you'll write vice versa case, which means you wrote advantage of renting an accommodation in the above paragraph. Now you'll write the disadvantage in the second one. And you've written disadvantage of own house, so you'll write advantage of own house in the second paragraph. Vice versa case. Understood?
Yes, ma'am.
Everybody has understood. I can still repeat it again. Yeah.
Hello. Yeah, ma'am. Can't we write the advantages of rented house advantages, disadvantages in one paragraph and own house advantages and disadvantages in one paragraph?
So we are comparing both. No. So we are comparing both. If we write one advantage of... So it doesn't make sense if we are writing both the advantages in one paragraph and disadvantages in another paragraph.
One advantage and one advantages and disadvantages of the rented house in one paragraph and advantages and disadvantages of own house in another paragraph.
So again, I'm saying we are trying to compare and contrast here. If you are writing one advantage of renting a house in the above in paragraph one of body, so we'll write one disadvantage of this of own house in the same paragraph, so that comparison is made. And then in the next paragraph, we'll compare the two again.
Okay.
If you can also try to write three paragraphs in this, three body paragraphs. Try to write one advantage and one disadvantage in separate paragraphs, and rest you can write it in the third paragraph. So if you're writing advantage of renting in the first paragraph, then you can write advantage of own house, and then you can mix the disadvantages of both. You can do it that way also, to simplify it.
Okay, thank you.
Piyush has a question, I guess. Yeah, please, Piyush.
Sir, what will be the time management strategy in between this essay writing? We have the 40 minutes.
You just have to maintain a time, 40 minutes. Time management will be 5 minutes initial, 30 minutes in the middle, and last will be 5 minutes. First 5 minutes, you have to look at the question, read the question very carefully, analyze what type of question it is, make important points. Making important points should be there in the very first 5 minutes. After making points, directly start writing, and always save the last 5 minutes to revise and edit, which we also call it proofreading. After writing something, since we'll be writing it with a pencil, or some of you will be doing it on the computer, you'll always have time to, you should always take out time to edit anything that you've written, because none of us can write perfect in one go. We have to read our entire article again after completing it. So 5:30 and 5 will be your management of time. You can manage it this way. Try to get into a habit of making the important points in the very first 5 minutes. Okay, the last type of scenario is outweigh overweigh. I would like to tell you all, first of all, outweigh, overweigh means something which is more significant. Now, the question is the same question. People of several nations prefer to stay in a rented accommodation while people of other nations prefer to buy their own house. Do the advantages of renting outweigh, which means is more important than the disadvantages of own house? Now, if you look at the question, they clearly do not pay attention on do the advantages. Just see before outweigh, overweigh, advantages of renting is mentioned, which means you will write two paragraphs of advantages of renting, one advantage in each paragraph, and you will write, and after outweigh, overweigh, there is disadvantages of an own house. You'll write one paragraph of disadvantage. Here, how we segregate the paragraph is, before the word outweigh, overweigh, whatever is written, we will write two paragraphs of that. And after the word outweigh, overweigh, whatever is written, we will write one paragraph of that. In this, we will write two paragraphs of advantages of renting, one advantage in different, in separate paragraphs, and then one disadvantage of own house in a separate paragraph. Now, how you can write it is, you have to write the first paragraph as your introduction, then write one advantage paragraph of renting, then one disadvantage paragraph of own house, and again one paragraph of advantage of renting, and finally conclude, the conclusion of the whole essay will be there. Is it clear?
Can you repeat?
Yes, please. You can see in the statement of the question that it says outweigh and
just hold on.
She overweigh. Can you see outweigh, overweigh in the question?
Yes.
Okay. Now, when outweigh, overweigh is written, anything before outweigh and overweigh will have two paragraphs. Okay. It says advantages of renting. So, advantages of renting is written before outweigh and overweigh. You will write two different paragraphs of advantages of renting. You'll write two advantages in different paragraphs. One advantage in one body paragraph, another advantage in another body paragraph. Then, disadvantages of own house is written after outweigh and overweigh, which means it is not very important. So, ABC, yeah, which means advantages of renting, is outweighing or is more important or is more significant than disadvantages of own house. That is the reason we are writing two advantages of renting and one disadvantage of own house.
Okay, so the
is
first
it clear?
Paragraph,
yeah,
the first paragraph will be advantage of renting.
So first paragraph will be introduction.
Yeah, introduction. Second would be advantage of renting.
One
first advantage.
Yes, 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 yes.
So another paragraph, body paragraph two would be next advantage of renting, and third paragraph would
yes.
be disadvantage of own house, right?
Own house, and then conclusion. Now, while writing this in this sequence, you can also write one advantage of renting, then one disadvantage of own house, then again one advantage of renting. You can use this sequence also.
Can you repeat that again, ma'am?
I am saying, rather than writing one advantage of renting, then again one advantage of renting, then one disadvantage of own house, you can write one advantage of renting, then one disadvantage of own house, then one advantage of renting. It is the same thing, but in a different pattern. Have you understood?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Can you repeat whatever you understood, please?
This can be written also like first paragraph, advantage of renting, and the second advantage of own house, and third paragraph again advantage of renting.
Good. Now, when we write it in this way, we are writing, we are actually trying to explain the question's motive of writing outweigh, overweigh. Outweigh, overweigh basically means something that is of more weightage than the other thing. Now, we are writing one advantage of renting, then we are writing one disadvantage of own house. Now we are trying to prove our point that yes, renting and advantage of renting is of more weightage than the disadvantage of own house. That is the reason we are writing again one more advantage of renting. Okay.
Hello, ma'am. Can I see?
Hi.
Yeah, hi. I see they are asking for our opinion, right? Indirectly, in this question, they are asking for our opinion, right? Hello.
Okay.
Hello.
Yeah, yeah, please go ahead.
Is it that we can write, we can write that no, the advantages of renting doesn't overweigh the disadvantage.
No,
like that.
No. No, okay. No.
So they are not asking for our opinion.
Yes, yes. Even if you look at the question of agree and disagree, they say to what extent do you agree and disagree? I understand that they are asking your opinion, but you will, only in agree and disagree, you will take a stand in the first paragraph of introduction and you will write, I completely agree or I completely disagree or I tend to be neutral. But when it comes to advantages and disadvantages, in the question, they are not in, so indirectly, if you look at the question, they are not asking for your opinion. They have already mentioned that yes, that advantage of renting is overweighing the disadvantages of an own house. You have to follow the sequence. This is a trick that they do.
Okay.
Yes, this is a basic trick that they are doing so that you get confused within how many paragraphs are to be written.
Okay.
So follow this structure. Whenever outweigh overweigh comes, whatever is written before outweigh overweigh will have two paragraphs, and anything that comes after outweigh overweigh will have one paragraph. Basic, simple technique.
Okay, ma'am.
Okay. The last one is discuss views. So these days, a lot of women are joining the police and military forces, the defense forces, and several people think that it's a good sign. Others, however, believe that these jobs are not suitable for them. Discuss both views and give your opinion. When you look at the statement of the question, the last statement will always tell you which type of essay it is. In the previous type of essay, they said, do the advantages or disadvantages, discuss the advantages and disadvantages. So you came to know that that was disadvantage, advantage type of essay. Here they say discuss both views and give your opinion, which means this is discuss views type of essay. Whenever this type of essay will come in the examination, you will always have two different views. So in this question, if we look at the first view is it's a good thing for women to join police and defense forces. Second view is it is not a good sign. So second view is that these jobs are not suitable for them, that women should not be joining it because it is not these kind of jobs are not suitable for women. Now, the question says discuss both views. You will, in one paragraph, you will discuss the first view. In another paragraph, you will discuss second view. And then you have to give your opinion. Your opinion can either be in favor of view A, which is it is a good sign, or view B, that these jobs are not suitable, or your view can be neutral, which means you can partially agree with view A or partially agree with view B. And introduction and conclusion paragraphs will be constant as one paragraphs each. Any questions?
In the introduction paragraph, we need to state our opinion, right?
First. No. While writing this type of essay, your opinion will come in a different paragraph. So here, look at the question. Discuss both views. Now, you know both means there are two views. Two different views will be discussed in two different paragraphs. Then it says, give your opinion. Your opinion will be discussed in a different paragraph. So body paragraph, so first paragraph is introduction. Then body paragraph one will have discussion of view A. One main point, body paragraph two will have your opinion, and then you will write the final conclusion of the essay. Your opinion will always have a different paragraph.
Okay, and so we need to make at least 40 words in introduction, right?
Don't look at the words. Just paraphrase anything that is given. You can always write 5-10 words extra. That is not a problem. They don't deduct marks in that thing. if it is above 10, if the words are extra or above 10, then your marks are deducted based on 0.5 or, you know, minus 1 ban. Okay. Introduction, conclusion, try to keep it little short because main paragraphs are body paragraphs.
Yes, ma'am. But at least we need to write two sentences in introduction, right? So,
yes,
if we make it as a paraphrasing and write the first sentence, then the second sentence, how it would be? Can you explain that?
See, the introduction of this, if I had to write it, I would have written, it can be attributed to the fact that different people have different opinions when it comes to females enrolling in the police and military forces or in the defense forces. Several individuals opine or several individuals are of the opinion that there is no harm in women joining the forces, while others think that these jobs are completely inappropriate for them.
Okay.
This is the introduction. 3 to 4 lines maximum.
Okay.
Here I've written online. I have asked the question.
Ma'am, I have seen in some essays, this essay will discuss both views and reach a conclusion like that. So, do we need to write like that?
No, I didn't understand. Can you please repeat it?
I have seen in some essays that they're adding one more sentence. That this essay will consider both views and write.
No. Please don't. No, please don't write that.
Okay.
Please don't write that. See, your content should be good. Okay. Only in agree and disagree. Please make sure. Do not use words like you, we, I. Do not write personalized words. Even if you're writing your opinion, you will not write I opine, I think that. No. You will write as per my opinion, in my opinion, as per my point of view, or in my point of view. Do not use words like you, we, and I.
Okay.
Okay, any questions? Hi, guys, any questions you have?
No, ma'am.
Okay, no questions. So today I have actually told you how you have to divide and write the paragraphs in these type of essays. In the next video, we'll actually tell you about the structures of introduction, conclusion, and body paragraph. How do you need to paraphrase? What kind of main points are to be written? And you know, what is the structure of writing the body paragraphs? So just told all of you, you can please come up and ask questions. No questions?
Guys, you can ask all your questions before we wind up. Like, we are about to hit 1 hour mark for today. So if you guys have any question, then you can ask us.
You can also write your questions in the email if you feel that right now you've understood everything, and when you start practicing you feel that you have doubts, you can also email us.
Yeah, I'm just leaving the email address in the chat. So you got, like, I've dropped my phone number if you guys need any assistance with writing, speaking, listening, or reading. You can always contact us. The number is in the chat, and the name of the website is ielsco.com. So you can come and join us. The same video will be available on YouTube also, so you can watch the same. If you have like missed out anything here, you can come and watch the video on YouTube. And I would suggest you and request you if you can share it as well with your friends. If you guys have any question, then you can ask us in the comment section on the YouTube, as well as any question you have, feel free to contact us. So If anybody has a question before we end up this session, please ask, or you can ask on the YouTube channel. Prabhjot, do you have any question?
No, sir. Thank you for the class. Thank you, Shruti ma'am, for the session. Ma'am, I have one question for you. Can you hear me? Is my voice audible to you?
Yes, it's audible to me. I think Shruti has left already.
Okay.
Yeah. So
if we are looking to show the material what we have wrote, how can we? I want to practice what ma'am teaches.
Okay, so what you can do is you can just write an essay and send it through us, and we'll correct it and give you the feedback on the same.
Okay, for me it is difficult to write on the computer because my typing is not much fast. So
no problem.
Can write a copy and send you the PDF or any docs.
So what you can do is on our IELTSCO website, you have an option to create a student panel for yourself. So okay. You can join us there. So any question you have related to your study material as well as submitting your writing task, you can do it there, and then we can evaluate it and give you the feedback.
Okay, sure.
We have a question from Basim. I have a question. Can I write a title to the essay? Boss, the trainer has left for the day. So you guys can ask all these questions on our YouTube channel. This video will be live there shortly, like within an hour or two. And then you guys can ask all your questions there. And then we'll be back again tomorrow or day after. We'll keep you guys posted. We'll send you an email regarding what time we are coming live next. And then you guys can ask all your questions again.
Okay, sure. If possible, kindly conduct a class of reading also.
Sure. Like, we can.
I'm taking reading.
Mm-hmm.
I'm taking the class for reading only.
Mm-hmm.
So kindly conduct a class for reading.
Perfect. We'll do that for sure. We have your email address. You'll be getting an email from us for the next webinar when we'll be doing
email
it.
Address?
I'm sorry.
You are having my email address.
I think that's how we got you here. Otherwise, you guys must have seen the post on the Facebook. So
yes.
Next time you see the post on Facebook, you can just click and join from there. Otherwise, you can definitely log on to IELTSCO.com and leave your email address there. We'll save it and we'll share the next meeting with you.
Sure. No problem.
So it's IELTSCO.com, IELTSCO.com.
Okay, sir. You can end the meeting.
Sure. So thank you guys. It was nice speaking to you, and we shall see you soon.
Thank you.
Thank you.